Hey guys, Don Diadre here again. We are still in the guild hall. I had the HU marker with me and already recorded the intro and how I did it, but there was a bit of a problem since Steam was fucking me over and sending me like 5 or 6 updates in one time, so
if anyone sneaks up on us,
I just put it in the offline mode and now I can decently record. I was forgot it, so sorry for that guys, but I'm still going to show you everything of this this mod, how you make it and stuff. You just got this HQ marker. It's just an item, you drop it on the ground. You can place it everywhere in the building or the area you want to have it, but it only got like a bit of a range where the guild members will walk. So I just put it behind this tree and hope it won't glitch out. I make a hard save for if it happens, but my goal for it, that it is here, is just if they spawn, they probably go cook here, sit on the table, that kind of stuff. This is just going to be like a little bit of a guild table, so hope everything will work fine with that. Today we are also going to get our first real member, since Shanti is going only to be a companion, so don't expect him to be really in the guild like that. So as you can see, I have this recruiting necklace. I get like options.
You are taking us somewhere warm.
Yeah, like here you see it in the menu, I'm starting a new guild, blah blah blah, but I'm not going to do it with Shanti. I made a companion myself. It's inspired by a character my friend Spooks is using. Also from this channel, of course. So it's not really a character he has in Skyrim, but it's a character he have in different kind of online games. So it is a female, but I think first we need to get her some items and clothes, since she spawned probably naked. That's not because I'm a pervert, but that's because I'm not good at modding. Since as I was saying earlier, I'm quite new to modding and I'm already glad I got like Shanti in the game. So I hope this one will work, and I believe she is at Riverwood, but first I think we need to go to Whiterun and craft her some nice guild armor. So let's go. Alright guys, we are in Whiterun. Oh, she's just going inside. How late is it? Oh, it's getting PM. Need to hurry up and first let's go to the companion thingy. They also sell supplies and I don't really want to go inside again, so and have a long loading screen. So just let's get some supplies. It's been a while since I've been in Whiterun, I must say. Only been here for selling the time scare. Shut up. Hey, he's moving. At least he's moving for me. Let's get the blessing. At least he's moving. Heimskers are getting scared. Don't really want to kill him yet. Maybe I will do it later on, but I want to do something really creative with that later on in my my series. So first, let's get some supplies.
Got a lot of steel to ship.
Right. Be praised. Nah, I'm not going to use that kind of stuff. Going to need some iron. I need some leather. I think that's it. Let's see how much we can make with this. Alright. Let's see. Armor. You know what? It'll maybe be cool. I'm not sure. I think I'm going to combine this with just regular armor, but yeah, alright. I'm not going to use this yet. This is for a special character. I think you guys are going to like that character, and I really love the mask, but that really is going to take some time, since maybe one other member than this one we are going to get is joining soon, but well, I think the character with the mask is going to take a little bit of time, since tomorrow I'm starting playing another mod. It's a bit of a story, it's new with a ship and stuff. I forgot the name, but it's new and everyone is very positive about it. Not many people reviewed it, so I'm going to do my best about it. So let's see. think we need this one. Yeah. It's a bit... I'm going to do something... It's not really tactical or something, but... well, it was Spooks' ID, so it's his character. It's based on his character in a lot of games, so... I'm going to do something stupid. It's a stupid combination, but... it's quite a fun combination, and I know in MMOs it's quite good, so... I think, yeah, let's get some steel and stuff like that. We need more materials.
You are taking us somewhere warm.
The cat keeps talking about going something warm. Just shut up and wait. I need to do some stuff. Can't stay into the base all day. Some people need to work. Maybe I got... Yeah, from the armor mod. Maybe something nice. Not into the barbarian stuff. Not sure what I can make. All kind of things, but... Maybe... Alright, I think maybe this is going to look good. If it doesn't look good, I will change it up. So, what is she doing? Stupid cat, follow me. Come on. Jesus Christ. But I think I see you guys in Riverwood. I think I'm just going to travel now, so see you guys there. Alright guys, we are in Riverwood, and as you can see, this is going to be our new and first member, but... first,
of course.
Let's invite her.
Excellent.
Hope everything is going to work. So, let's give her the stuff. So. Right. Let's see. Mercenary armor and a nice green hood. Then I need to put something else. I think. As you can see, you have your like jobs and collecting, and but first let's equip the stuff. And she's wearing it. Too bad she didn't have the bow yet, but maybe I can fix one later for her. But well, she is the type of archer character. But as you can see, she is just going to her guild now, so. First, I need to check some stuff out. Need to put my hood on again, since if you have like two, it will be a bit glitchy. And I'm going to put my chain on. I'm not using the recruiting necklace for a while now, so yeah. Let's also get a little bit back to the base, I think. I hope you guys like the new member, since I did some things in the editing and. It's not really like I made it, but I had to convert something or something like that. I'm not really experienced with the mod tools, but I had like face paint on her, but it disappeared. But it doesn't look too bad, and since she is wearing a hood, you don't really see it. But too bad the bow isn't working what I did. I think I already know what I did wrong, so next character doesn't have problems like that, so... But let's wait for 1 hour so she can go to the base. And I think we just take a little walk. I know we did this walk a lot, but as you can see, we are not that far away from our base. So let's walk a bit and check out the other route, since today I'm just going to take this route. It's not much of a difference, but I think we are faster than at the guild hall. I really hope everything is going to work and stuff like that. Don't... Oh, that's a little wolf. Yeah, I can insta-kill him now. I'm quite a high level now, so it's not much of a problem anymore. But yeah, I really hope everything is going to work in the guild, since I think I'm going to put him on a job one at a time, since... I know if you have like a lot of members and you let them do all kind of jobs, it can get a bit unstable. And since I'm only used to the the regular in-game houses like the one in Solitude and stuff like that when testing the mod, I'm not sure how this will impact the game. So, but as you see, now we're at the grotto and I think we just need to go inside. Alright guys, we are back inside and let's see if she is walking around here. I hope so, but I think I can... Yeah, nice. She's already sitting at the table. That's a good thing. That's a good thing. It's exactly working like I wanted to, so... That's great news. Yeah, the companion is working like 50% of what I want, so... At least that's something. I already knew Shanti would be working since I followed it step by step, but this time I just did it without watching other YouTubers making one, so... Just trying it a bit out myself, some different settings. Mm. It's not the best, but
it will
work. And let's see if we can... Nah, sometimes they still have inventory and then it will
Make
glitch,
it
so
quick.
You need to clean it up.
It
but
would seem so.
I think we are going to send her on a little job. We can let her assassinate, alchemy ingredient collecting, good deeds, wrecking havoc, hunt... Stealing stuff, treasure finding, slaughter dragons, skooma business. That sounds interesting, but well, I think we just have do something simple. Maybe collect some alchemy ingredients.
Gold solves most problems, doesn't it?
Oh yeah, you need to pay them. It will take 84 hours. They can fill their job, but. If you just train them a bit, they are getting better at it. And I know if you go do things like treasure hunting, well, they can come back with nice treasure, nice items, and a lot of gold. So let's train her a bit and let her do the simple jobs now. But where's Shanti going? Ah, there is she. He's always just sneaking around. Or I'm just not looking right, but... Alright, let's go here. We still have some smithing stuff, so I think I'm just going to store it here, or... Yeah, I think I'm going to store it here. Since I don't want to walk around with all these bars and leather, since it's quite heavy and... I don't like walking around with that heavy stuff. I'm going to keep the recruiting necklace with me, since... not sure if we are going to make custom-only companions, since... I only, also have a mod with other companions, so maybe I will add them too to the guild, but I'd rather make them myself. I know they're not the best quality and stuff like that, but I think it will add more immersion to the story I'm a bit creating. A bit of the, well, the guild is also called it, but a bit of the family I'm creating of different kind of members. I will also let them do their own kind of type of job, so we have like... Bit of an archer type, that's more for hunting, assassination, that kind of stuff. And we will have like a bit of an orcish guy or something like that. Not sure if it will be an orc, but like a brute with a big axe. He's more something for murdering out a village. We're also going to make like maybe heroes or something like that for killing dragons. We're just going to have different kind of people and different kind of tasks. So I think it will work out well in the end, but... I think I'm just need to do some stuff now, so let's see what kind of sword you. Oh yeah, we had like this sword, but I think I want to make a better one. But let's first see. Yeah, let's see the blacksmith. See what we can make and stuff like that. Don't think I got much custom. Ah, it's dwarven. Got a dwarven blade. Didn't know that. Yeah, Drake already. Oh yeah, those are the special bows I own. It's also a nice little mod. As you can see, you can make from humans. You can make like a boat. It's a bit psychopathic, but I like it. So got like custom jewelry, like rings and stuff like that. It's just from Heartfire. A lot of armors, but I think everyone knows this mod, so I'm not even going to well explain much about it, since it's just the basic mods, I think. But first... Oh yeah, it's got assassin stuff. I'm looking for something, but not sure what. Oh yeah, steel, sorry. That's stupid. I know there's like one sword I really want, but... I'm not sure if it was like in steel, but... I've seen it on the picture. This one's also nice with gold. A bit of a Templar sword. What's this? Gungnir. Lot of weapons and stuff. I really like those mods. Something I never had on... On Xbox and stuff like that. You're really missing out if you play on Xbox or stuff. Of PlayStation or... I don't know where you all have it on, but... I think the only real console for games like this is really a PC, since... Yeah, as you can see, Imperials with this sword will also be epic. I know there are a few mods, but yeah, I got so much stuff, so not going to show them all to you, but just wanted to show you a bit what I got in my armory, so it's not all I know. I still need to do the Daedric and stuff like that. He's going to fix a blade up or something. What are you doing?
Sneaks up on us. I'll smell them coming.
We are in our sanctuary and you think people are going to sneak up on us. Okay. Sometimes they really are stupid with that regular lines. I know Inigo or something, the other Khajiit, the purple one. I'm not sure from who the mod was, but that is also a very awesome mod. It adds so much more immersion to your companions, but I'm not great at modding, so I'm not even going to try stuff like that. I mean, it's just insane. He just responds to everything. He can give like a full report what you did and, well, what you did in all your playthrough, what decisions she like, what decisions she don't like, that kind of stuff. So, oh yeah, and this is what I want to show you guys. There's still like one extra bed. So, in the last video, I thought there was like no bed for the companions, but at least we got one. So, it's a bit of a mess here, but not going to do stuff with that. But really wanted to check also this out. Ah, that's the mannequin. Alright, some items. I think most of these are from the Thief Guild or something. It's a weapon rack. There's a little dagger there. It really is a nice detailed base of operations or house, how you want to call it. I still really like it and I hope you guys like it too, since I think I stay with this, but for now, I just want to tell you guys a little bit more about what I'm going to do tomorrow, and I really hope the mod is working, but I believe it's a story about a ship. They say you got at least 20 or 30 minutes playthrough, so maybe one or two episodes will cover it, but after that, I believe you can recruit different kind of people, as I told also in the last episode, like sailors and stuff. I'm not sure how it's implemented. Didn't read it for long. A bit global, I read it. It's not like I read every line of it, the description of the mod, but it really looks promising, and it only had like 7 comments, but they were all very positive, so I really want to do it. I have seen that not all the big channels already have like covered it, like Bro Duel. I mean, that guy's awesome. If you if you really want more in-depth talk about mods, I think you should check him out, since yeah, he's really the channel to go for looking that kind of stuff up, so I'll also use it. But I hope he's also going to cover it, since I think for information that's better. But I really want to do the playthrough, and I heard the ship at the end of the thing is really awesome, so I think that's something I really want to do, and hope to see you guys in that episode. I think I will leave it here for now, and I think I'm going to brew some potions today, so thanks for watching, and hope to see you at the ship.